Hello there, my RPG lovers, and welcome to another video. The first Two Worlds game created a lot of hype back in 2006 when it was announced. Some people were calling it the Oblivion Killer even before Oblivion officially released, but when it finally came out in 2007, it quickly became obvious that Two Worlds is a major disappointment, to say the least. Especially to those people who expected to find a similar production value like in Oblivion.
And why should I not go back there, pray?
If you can ignore bad animations, hilariously bad voice acting, hideous character models, and some other problems, you could probably enjoy some interesting gameplay features that this game offers. It's also worth mentioning that DRM in this game caused a lot of problems to some people, and they got stuck while trying to activate the game. But people soon forgot about the Oblivion Killer, and went back to play Oblivion, I guess. However, this doesn't mean the game didn't sell well. Two Worlds was bought by 1.5 million people, which is really insane when you think about it. Topware Interactive, the publisher for this game, was really happy with sales numbers because why they wouldn't be. So the sequel was to be expected. Two Worlds 2 released in 2010, and it was a major improvement over the first game in almost all aspects. I had a lot of praises for the magic system in this game because it was truly outstanding and unique. I've made a video about it a couple of months ago, so you can check that out if you're interested. Anyway, the reception was pretty decent by fans and the critics, but if we take everything in consideration, Two Worlds 2 was really mediocre in general. Fast forward to 2017, Topware Interactive thought it was a good idea to include microtransactions in the game. 7 years after the release of the game, somehow they thought this was a good idea. But we skipped some really important events that happened before this. Two Worlds 2 got one major DLC in 2011 called Pirates of the Flying Fortress, and it was pretty decent. Pretty much everyone thought that this is the last piece of content for Two Worlds 2, but that's far away from the truth. 2013 is probably the biggest turning point for Reality Pump because a couple of really important people left the studio and moved to CD Projekt Red. At the time, Reality Pump worked on a game that you may not even heard about called Raven's Cry. Even if you heard about it, you probably forgot it exists, and for a good reason. It was on so many worst games of 2015 lists, and a final nail in the coffin for Reality Pump. They even re-released the game in late 2015 with a new name, Vendetta: Curse of Raven's Cry. It was supposed to fix a lot of issues, but even that version was filled with bugs and glitches. It was nowhere near the quality of Two Worlds 2, and that's saying something. It was obvious the studio suffered a lot after the departure of those key people. Shortly after this, Reality Pump unfortunately went bankrupt and shut down. Fortunately, they were picked up by their former publisher Topware Interactive, which is great because people get to keep their job, but it's also really concerning. Now that Topware Interactive is in full control of Reality Pump, they probably get to make all major decisions that may greatly impact the development direction of, well, everything. The first red flag is obviously those microtransactions they decided to implement in Two Worlds 2 back in 2017. It was a very sneaky and scummy move to try and squeeze some extra dollars from an old game. Along with those microtransactions, they released another big DLC for Two Worlds 2 called Call of Tenebrae. I didn't play it myself, so I can't criticize, but it currently has mixed reviews on Steam. A couple of smaller DLCs released in the same year, but check this out. Two Worlds 2 got another big DLC less than a month ago. It's called Shattered Embrace, and besides new content, Two Worlds 2 got a major engine update. And again, I didn't play this, so I don't know how good it is, but I will probably try it out soon. It's definitely really interesting how this single player RPG from 2010 is still getting major content updates. But what about Two Worlds 3? Is that even happening? Shortly after Topware Interactive acquired Reality Pump, they announced Two Worlds 3 and it was supposed to come out in 2019. But near the end of 2018, we found out that Two Worlds 3 is still in pre-production and it won't release for another 4 to 5 years. Yep, you heard that right. At the time, Reality Pump was focusing on the last piece of downloadable content, Shattered Embrace, which is now available for purchasing, so that probably means that Reality Pump now shifted all their attention to Two Worlds 3. To be honest, I don't have a lot of hope for the sequel, mainly because of the business practices of Topware Interactive. One of the main reasons for Raven's Cry failure was the lack of manpower. People who left the team were described as very talented developers, and we can only hope that Topware Interactive hired more people of the same profile. I'm really hoping I'm wrong about this, but it seems like Topware doesn't know what to do with this IP. That's just the impression I'm getting after taking in consideration what was going on with Two Worlds 2. But apparently, we'll need to wait quite a bit to get any new info about the Two Worlds 3. We can only hope that Topware Interactive will provide the developers with everything they need to make a decent sequel and try not to ruin it with microtransactions, please. Anyway, tell me your opinions about the Two Worlds franchise. Leave a comment down below. If you like the video, press the thumbs up button and subscribe for more content. Click on the bell icon so you don't miss any future uploads. Special thanks to my Patreons and YouTube exclusive members, and if you as well want to become one of them, all the links are in the description. And I'll see you in the next one.